In Paris, tens of thousands of protesters took to the streets on Sunday to demonstrate against the adoption of a European fiscal pact and further economic austerity. The French Parliament is due to debate President Hollande's proposed budget this week. Archie's Maria Finochina is in Paris for us.
Dozens of French NGOs and trade unionists have taken to the streets of Paris today to manifest against a document known as a fiscal pact. It was prepared earlier this March by EU leaders, including then the President of France, Nicolas Sarkozy, and German Chancellor Angela Merkel, and it enforces strict and much tougher financial and fiscal discipline from the EU members, and it requires them to slash the public deficit dramatically or to be punished, to be fined. If this treaty is ratified, that means France will be obliged to reduce its budget by 30 billion euros, and dramatically, just huge sum of money. And of course, it will affect life here in France dramatically, life of ordinary people, I mean. This budget documents is already ready. It's been revealed recently, and it says that it proposes to save 30 billion euros by cutting public spending and by increasing taxes. And of course, this is something that's not going to help economic growth, but instead may lead to stagnation. This is what people who've come here today are protesting against, and they are calling for the opposite. They say the country's economy right now needs more spending and lower taxes.
We don't want austerity in France because Europe wants to pressure us to stop our country from investing in public sectors like education.
We are protesting against austerity in Europe, and everybody knows that austerity leads to recession.
We are against the imposition of the austerity plan. It will be very difficult for us. Of course, we don't want that.
Economic crisis is engulfing Europe these days, and austerity measures have led to nationwide protests in many countries, and protesters have been clashing with police. So dramatic events have been taking place all throughout Europe, and many here today fear that France could be the next country to face this reality, this dramatic reality, and they say they've come here to protest to avoid these negative consequences and not to repeat the mistakes of other EU members. Marie-Finochina, RT, Paris, France.